It's Jules, and I'm feeling really good right now. We just went to the gym, my husband and I, and we had a really nice dinner at Cheesecake Factory, and I read an amazing article, and now I am talking to you guys about it because I found it to be really inspirational, and I wanted to make a video right away. So, the article is called How to Go From Dreaming to Doing. Four Steps to Motivation. It's a Time magazine article by Eric Barker. And basically, this is about how to accomplish any dream that you want to accomplish, whether it's something you wanted for a short period of time or something that you've dreamed of forever. If you are like me, you might find that the hardest thing when you have a goal or a dream is to go from dreaming it to doing it. Once you've accomplished the goal, you can continue doing it. For example, once you've become a person who's health conscious and goes to the gym, going to the gym isn't that big of a deal. You go and it feels like, nothing. But if, when you're somebody who never exercises, to become somebody who does exercise, that first jump is the hardest. So, this is a trick to make you go from dreaming to doing simply in four steps using a simple acronym called WOOP. WOOP. Now, let's talk about how to put this to work. So, wishing. Okay. A lot of us hear growing up that wishing is a good thing, that it's a positive thing to sit and fantasize and dream about what you want to be. But what the WOOP method tells us is that wishing and fantasizing can, in fact, be dangerous. Now, is it good to wish? Is it good to spend some time daydreaming? Absolutely, because you need to visualize what you want before you go out and get it, right? But where we can get caught up is when you get fixated on daydreaming and imagining. Oftentimes, you then don't go out and actually do. And this might be a silly example, but the thing that I probably fantasize the most about in my life is winning the lottery. Now, it's a silly example because almost nobody wins the lottery. The odds are close to zero. However, I will sit there and I do it with my husband and we will fantasize, we'll talk about it, we'll imagine every single person who will help with our money and every place that we'll travel and everywhere that we'll buy a house. And sometimes we'll do that and then we won't even go out and buy a ticket. We'll sit there for an hour and fantasize and dream and daydream about being rich, and then we don't even go out to the gas station and buy ourselves that 0.00001 chance of winning it. You can apply that to anything in your life. If you sit there long enough and fantasize and fantasize and, oh, I'll do this and I would do that and I would be this and I would be that, you have to be careful because sometimes it feels so good that it just stops there and you don't take it on to the next step. Just food for thought. Next is outcome. So the way they describe it in the article is by setting an outcome, you're crystallizing your wish. So whatever it may be, you make your wish clear and then you set your desired outcome and you make that clear. So if your wish is to make more money, your outcome may be getting a raise at work. If your wish is to become an actress, your outcome might be booking a role in a play. If your wish is to meet Mr. or Mrs. Right, your outcome might be joining a club or getting out of the house more or joining a dating website. So pick a specific outcome that will crystallize your wish. Next is obstacles. To me, this is the most interesting part of the whole method because it really contradicts everything that we have learned about accomplishing things as far as what we do mentally. We live in a society where we are very, very fixated on positivity. So when you want something, we're told you envision yourself getting it. Before the big race, you imagine yourself winning or the secret. If you tell yourself over and over and over that you're rich or you see yourself having money, then you will bring the money to you. Well, in this case, that is not true. This says you will have a much greater chance of success if you actually envision every single obstacle that could get in the way of what you want to do, because it will prepare you. When you don't prepare for obstacles, you essentially aren't prepared, and that will cause you to fail. So here's a quote directly from the article. They call this mental contrasting. We look to envision what could go wrong. what will go wrong in advance before we start, for too many ambitious undertakings fail for preventable reasons. Far too many people don't have a backup plan because they refuse to consider something might not go exactly as they wish. Now, when I go into auditions typically, I go prepared with the exact material that I have and I say, I'm going to memorize this, I'm going to think of what my character wants, I'm going to make unique decisions that'll make me stand out, and I'm going to do a great job, right? Let's say I don't imagine any possible thing that could go wrong. Well, then let's say I step into the room and they say, oh, no, we're not doing that scene. Put that down. We're going to do this scene from the end of the movie, something that I had not even prepared. Well, had I done mental contrasting, it probably would have crossed my mind that anything could happen and I need to read the entire script because maybe I won't do exactly what I think I'm going to do. Do you see what I mean? So it's actually really helpful for you to imagine your obstacles and prepare yourself, and then you'll be one step ahead of everybody. Another really cool thing that happens with mental contrasting is that they did a study and it proved that it actually dissuaded some people from pursuing dreams that were too hard and high to reach. Now, that's a very taboo thing to say. You're supposed to say, oh no, any dream is possible. You can do anything you want. But let's be real, at 29 years old, I'm probably not going to be the president of the United States one day, right? I mean, who knows? Maybe I could. But I'm going to sit there and I'm going to go through my list of obstacles. This might not be true for everyone, but in my case, maybe I'm a little lazy. When I think of the list of obstacles that I would have to go through to become the president of the United States, I'd probably change my direction a little bit and go towards something that's a little bit more attainable for me so that I can have success a little bit sooner in life. So that is the way in which being negative can be positive. Okay, now the last step is to plan. You make a plan. Now that you have dreamed what it is that you want, you have chosen the way that you are going to accomplish that, you have set the obstacles in your mind that might come your way, you now have to make a plan for those obstacles, okay? So the way that they recommend you do this is with if-then statements. For example, if your goal is to lose weight, if I am at dinner tonight and I'm offered a piece of cake, then I'm just going to have coffee instead. If I want to be prepared for my audition tomorrow, then I should read the entire script so I'll be ready for anything. So if-then statements are crucial in your final level of preparedness and making your dream turn into reality. I'm going to read again directly from the article. Napoleon Hill said, "Think positive. Tell yourself you can do it," like saying, "I will make $1 million. It's the secret all over again. But Bob the Builder, you guys know who that is. My brother used to love Bob the Builder. He's a little animated character on a children's show. Bob the Builder doesn't make a statement. He asks kids a question. Can we build this? Seems like a tiny difference, but questions are powerful. It makes you realistically consider the problem. Questioning builds plans, and plans help you be more productive, beat stress, and even increase happiness. Now let's try this right now because I want to show you that this isn't just some vague idea, this isn't some abstract thought or method of accomplishing things. This is actually a way that within the next 30 seconds, you can go from dreaming to doing. And it's really cool once you put it to work like this. So let's start. Number one, wish. What do you dream of achieving in the future? And if you want to pause this video for a second and think about it, I'll let you do that and then come back. What do you dream about achieving in the future? Next, outcome. What form will that result take? Be specific. Now that you know how to get where you want, let's put number three into action. Obstacles. What stands in your way? Now we're on the last step, plan. If and when that obstacle comes about, how will you overcome it? Use an if-then statement. If this happens, then I will do that. Now I'll give you a second again to think about it. Do you realize how quickly your thought, your idea just turned into a plan? You have just created, in that minuscule amount of time, a full-blown blueprint of how you are going to accomplish your dream. That's how fast it can happen. Now I'm going to finish out this video with a great quote from the end of the article, and it's by Stephen J. Ross, and it says, "There are three categories of people. The person who goes into the office, puts his feet up on the desk, and dreams for 12 hours. The person who arrives at 5 a.m. and works 16 hours, never once stopping to dream. And the person who puts his feet up, dreams for 1 hour, then does something about those dreams. And if you are that person, there is nothing you can't accomplish." I hope this has helped you as much as it helped me. When I read this article, I became so excited, and I hope it excites you too. Please let me know how this technique is working for you in your life as you start to use it. Talk about it with each other in the comments below. Let's all come together to make ourselves and help each other be the happiest and healthiest, most accomplished people that we want to be. All right, guys, I'll see you soon. Until next time.